Hello students, welcome to my channel Agriculture Engineering Online. This is a problem from GATE 2014, that is question number 49. This is about heating of milk from temperature 25 degree Celsius to 85 degree Celsius with steam bath. All the data are given. The volume of the milk is 282.7 centimeter cube and surface area is given 245 centimeters. So, and also the overall heat transfer coefficient is given. And heat capacity is also given. Let us quickly go to the solution part. First of all, the volume of the milk is given. Volume of milk, that is 282.7 centimeter cube. And also density is given. So density of milk, that is given. There is 1030 kg per meter cube. Since this is given in meter cube and this is centimeter cube, so quickly convert the mass of the milk, mass of the milk to be heated. That is, let it m milk mm. So that is, let it 282.7 centimeter cube into multiply by 10 to the power minus 6, that is meter cube per centimeter cube, and 1030 kg per meter cube. So you see, meter cube cancel out, centimeter cube cancel out, so that will be 0.291 kg of milk to be heated. So this is by a steam bath. So if the container is having milk at a temperature of initial temperature 25 degrees Celsius, final temperature to be 85 degrees Celsius. So this is by a steam bath, let it be. Steam temperature is 100 degree Celsius. So there will be constant temperature, heating will be there. Now coming to the specific heat capacity of the milk is given. Specific heat capacity, that is C, is given. That is 3.9 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So 3.9 kilojoule, so you can easily convert it 3.9 into 10 to the power 3 joule per kg Kelvin, so it will be easier. And also the area of the exchanging area is given, the space area of the container is given. There is 245 centimeter square. Again you have to convert it into meter square, so multiplying by 10 to the power minus 4, it will be 0.0245 meter square. So everything should be in meter square and joule and kg, so that it will be easily calculated. Now next, everything is given. Also the overall heat transfer coefficient, that is U, is given. That is 1136 watt per meter square per Kelvin. So now also there is thermal conductivity is given, which is not required because here actually overall heat transfer coefficient is given, so inside that thermal conductivity or everything should be incorporated. So now coming to the Newton's law of cooling. So Newton's law of heating or cooling, so we know the equation is like this. E to the power minus alpha t. So where actually delta T0 is the initial temperature difference. So temperature difference at the starting of heating. So what is that difference between 100 degree steam and milk? That is 25 degrees Celsius milk and steam was 100 degrees. So therefore the delta T will be equal to 100 minus 25. It's no matter, it's in centigrade. So its Kelvin also will be same, difference will be there. Therefore, 75 will be the 75 degree Kelvin will be the delta T0, temperature difference at the initial, and delta T will be equal to temperature difference at the after heating, after time T. So that therefore the temperature difference at the end of heating, you can say heating, that will be equal to 100 degree minus 85 degree, that is 15 degree Kelvin. So this is known. Now what is alpha? Alpha is called the rate constant. which depends on the overall heat transfer coefficient, area of the heating, mass of the milk to be heated, and also the heat capacity of the milk. So therefore, generally the alpha is equal to U, A, Y and C. So this is actually alpha. In this case, everything is given. So therefore, putting del T by del T 0. So del T is 15, del T 0 is 75. There should be equal to e to the power minus instead of alpha, you can everything you can put. U is 1136 into A is 0.0245 divided by mass is 0.291 and C is 3.9 into 10 to the power 3 and into T. See, that T is the time of heating. We have to calculate in second. So because everything, if you see here, watt per meter square per Kelvin and joule per second is there, because what is joule per second, so everything will cancel out, so T will be there. So therefore, putting everything into the equation, we can quickly solve the problem. That is 15 by 17 is 1 by 5. So putting ln together, so then this will be equal to minus everything calculation, then it will be 0.0245 T. So therefore, that is minus. So therefore, T will be log 1/5 will be equal to minus 1.61. That will be equal to minus 0.0245 T, which implies that T will be equal to minus 1.61 divided by minus 0.0245 T. 45 will be equal to 65.7 seconds. So this is the answer. So the heating time required to heat that milk from 25 to 85 will be 65.7 seconds. So this is the answer for this question. So hope you understand. Please like and subscribe to my channel.